Well, summer holiday booking is in full swing, but how can you get the vacation you deserve without breaking the bank? Well, joining me today with their top tips on how to get the most for your money, as well as to warn us about some of those holiday booking pitfalls, is travel journalist Simon Calder and from House Trip, Nilan Pieris. So welcome, guys. Now, Simon, it's cold, it's rainy. Is now the best time to book a holiday? Are we more likely to get a better deal if we wait, do you think?
That all depends on how flexible you are. If you're able to take off at a moment's notice, if you don't look too fussed about where you go, and crucially, you can avoid school holidays, then there will certainly be some good deals around for those who wait. However, if you're constrained to taking your trip outside of school terms, if you know roughly where you want to go, then plenty to be said for booking now. But for goodness sake, make sure you don't squander any of your hard-earned cash. Interesting, a survey from House Trip said that actually about one in five people have been put off taking a holiday this year simply because they don't feel they can afford it.
So if we're looking to get the most for our money, what are the sort of top destinations that you would recommend then, Nilan?
Vacation rentals really open up top European destinations that would probably be out of your reach normally. So looking at places like Paris, Barcelona, and even places like Tuscany, where the prices for hotels can be really, really high. And the prices for vacation rentals, I mean, on House Trip we have great apartments in Paris, overlooking the Champs-Élysées, going from as little as £36 per night for a family of two.
Well, I'm going to be there right now. So what are your top tips then, Simon? Just three top tips on booking a destination for getting the best value for money.
Well, they come down to basically shop around. Make sure you're getting the best possible deal for your transportation. Now, if the airfares look very high, then it's very easy to check around and see if you move your departure date by a day or two, whether you're going to save some cash. And if it still looks too expensive, think about packing everybody into the family car and driving over to the continent. Next, don't forget that holiday money is one of the easiest things to lose quite a lot of money on. The worst thing you can do is change money at the airport or on the ferry. Far better to organise it in advance. And thirdly, be aware of the sheer breadth of accommodation opportunities that there are at the moment. You don't have to put up with camping. You don't have to splash out on five-star luxury. Renting somebody else's apartment in a European city, I've tried it in several locations, is a way of getting fantastic value and giving you more money to spend on food and entertainment and, of course, all important tourist attractions.
Absolutely. Well, that brings me on to my question to you, actually. If people are looking for a different way to book a holiday, what's your advice, Nilan?
My advice is to try out vacation rentals. It's now easier than ever to book a vacation rental. At House Trip, we focused on a really simple six-step booking process. There's no contracts, no need for a wire transfer, just literally search for the dates that you're looking for in the locations that you're interested in, and put your credit card details in, and then you've secured your rental.
Well, that's all good news to us there. So thanks to Simon Calder and Nilan Pieris for joining us. If you want to find out more about the holidays House Trip has to offer, then go to www.housetrip.com. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.